Welcome to this tutorial on creating Turnitin assignments in myCourses, created by the Instructional Media Center at the Mississippi State University Libraries. To begin, log into myCourses by visiting mycourses.msstate.edu and entering your NetID and password. Once you are in myCourses, your course list can be found at the bottom of the center column. Select a course where you are the instructor. This will take you to your course page. Turnitin assignments are added to content areas. Select an existing content area or create a new one by mousing over the plus sign and clicking Content Area. For this tutorial, we will create a content area named Assignments. Check Available to Users and click Submit. Click on the New Content Area. Turnitin assignments can be found under the Assessments menu. Mouse over Assessments and select Turnitin Assignment. To begin, we will create a paper assignment. Click Next Step. In the first settings we see, we can title our assignment, assign a point value, the start date, which is the date that students can begin submitting assignments, the due date, and the post date, which is the date the students will be able to view comments and grades you have added to their assignments. Click on Optional Settings. Here in the first two options, you can include instructions for the assignment and choose whether or not to allow submissions after the due date. Under the Originality Report options, the first option, Immediately First Report is Final, will not allow students to resubmit the assignment. The second will allow students to resubmit the assignment until the due date, and the third will generate the reports on the due date, which also allows the student assignments to be compared with one another. The next three options allow for certain elements to be excluded from the originality reports. These settings can also be changed from within individual assignments. You can choose whether or not the students get to see the originality reports, and you can also choose when grades will be posted, either as you enter them or on the post date. Submitting papers to the standard Turnitin paper repository allows student papers to be compared to one another, as well as future submissions. You can also choose whether to compare the papers to the existing student paper repository, internet sources, and periodicals, journals, and publications. The grade mark options allow rubrics to be attached to the assignment. You can create your own rubric or search for one that matches your assignment. You can also choose whether or not to use the ETS E-Rater grammar checker. Finally, you can set these optional settings as the defaults for future Turnitin assignments. Click Submit when done. Click OK on the confirmation page. Now you will see a list of your Turnitin assignments. To access and grade student submissions, click on Course Tools and select Turnitin Assignments. Click on the assignment you want to grade, and this will take you to the assignment inbox for that assignment. You will see a list of all student submissions. Click on the title of the assignment to open the grade mark window. In the grade mark window, you can view the document and add comments. To add a comment to a line of text, highlight the line and then click the highlighted text. You can enter your comment, change the color of the highlight, and save it as a quick mark to be used later. If you have a rubric attached to this assignment, you can also reference which criterion is related to the comment. After you've made your comments, you can grade the assignment in the top right corner of the window. Or, if you have a rubric attached, you can click the rubric icon at the bottom right and enter grades into the rubric. To check the originality of the document, click on Originality in the top left corner. This will then highlight any text that has been found in other papers in the Turnitin repository. Under the Match Overview section, you can click the arrow to get more information about the match. At the bottom right of the window, you can also adjust your filtering options. Here you can exclude text found between quotation marks, exclude the bibliography section, and adjust the match settings. Changes made in this window are automatically saved to Turnitin. Close the window to go back to your assignment inbox. Thanks for watching this tutorial on Turnitin. If you have any questions or would like more handouts or tutorials, visit our website at library.msstate.edu.